temporary abandonment was the Deepwater Horizon's last operation on the Macondo well. This animation describes BP's temporary abandonment procedure and how BP developed the procedure. The Deepwater Horizon's job was to drill the Macondo well. BP, like most operators, would give the job of completing and producing oil from the well to a smaller and less costly rig, which would install hydrocarbon collection and production equipment. To make way for the new rig, the Deepwater Horizon's crew would remove its riser and blowout preventer from the wellhead. Before they could do those things, the crew first had to secure the well through a process called temporary abandonment. During the temporary abandonment procedure, the rig crew would take the well from the configuration on the left, which is what the well looked like at the end of the cement job, to the configuration on the right, which is what the well would look like after the Deepwater Horizon left the Macondo well site. MMS required BP to install a cement plug as a backup seal to secure the well while the Deepwater Horizon was gone. BP engineers decided that the rig crew would install this plug deep in the well, roughly 3,000 feet below the seafloor. Before doing so, the rig crew would replace the 3,000 feet of drilling mud in the well above the cement plug with much lighter seawater. The crew would also set a lockdown sleeve to lock the production casing into the wellhead. BP's temporary abandonment procedure had the following basic sequence. 1. Run the drill pipe into the well to 8,367 feet, 3,300 feet below the mud line. 2. Displace 3,300 feet of mud in the well with seawater, pushing the mud up above the BOP and into the riser. 3. Perform a negative pressure test to assess the integrity of the well and the bottom hole cement job. 4. Displace the mud in the riser with seawater. 5. Set the cement plug at 8,367 feet. And 6. Set a lockdown sleeve. BP's chosen temporary abandonment procedure had several important consequences. First, by removing so much mud, BP's procedure severely underbalanced hydrostatic pressures in the well. That underbalance would put significant stress on the bottom hole cement job. Second, and more importantly, BP's procedure would leave only one physical barrier in place during displacement of the riser with seawater, the bottom hole cement job. The blowout preventer would provide a backup barrier, but only if someone on the rig activated it. This was a minimally redundant configuration. It forced BP and the rig crew to rely heavily on the cement job, the negative pressure test of the cement job, and the vigilance and responsiveness of a crew during the riser displacement process. The blowout occurred during riser displacement. BP's engineers developed the Macondo temporary abandonment procedure by reasoning backwards. The engineers were concerned that any operations done after setting the lockdown sleeve might damage the sleeve, so they would set the lockdown sleeve last. Setting the lockdown sleeve required 100,000 pounds of downward force. They would generate that weight by hanging approximately 2,500 feet of drill pipe underneath the sleeve. To leave room for that drill pipe, they would set the cement plug even farther down in the well, 3,000 feet below the mud line. And because they preferred to set cement plugs in seawater, they would replace the mud in the well with seawater first. As a result, BP created a procedure in which the crew would displace 8,367 feet of mud in the well with seawater before installing any additional barriers. BP developed its temporary procedures at the last minute, apparently without conducting any rigorous risk analysis. BP changed the procedure numerous times in the 2 weeks leading up to April 20th. For example, BP's April 12th drilling plan stated that it would 1. Set the lockdown sleeve before setting the cement plug, and 2. Set the cement plug in seawater, just 6,000 feet below sea level, as opposed to 8,367 feet. The April 12th plan did not include a negative pressure test. On April 14th, BP changed the plan. A BP engineer sent an email setting forth a procedure that included a negative pressure test and that would require the crew to set the cement plug in mud before displacing the riser with seawater. On April 15th, BP changed the plan again. BP now planned to conduct a negative pressure test before setting the cement plug, and then to displace the wellbore and set the plug in seawater. This plug would be set deep in the well, at 8,367 feet. If MMS did not approve the use of such a deep plug, BP planned to revert to a plan in which it would set the lockdown sleeve early in the process and set a shallow cement plug at 5,367 feet. On April 16th, BP sent a permit application to MMS describing its proposed temporary abandonment procedure. The permit requested permission to set a deep plug. MMS approved the application in less than 90 minutes. The plan changed one more time the day of the blowout. On April 20th, a BP engineer emailed an ops note to the Macondo team in which he described a final temporary abandonment procedure that was different from the one BP filed with MMS. This new procedure specified for the first time that the rig crew would combine the negative pressure test procedure with displacement of the riser with seawater.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon, so you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.